Hi, I'm Nishu, and today I'm going to present a program to find maximum of two given 8-bit numbers using 8085 assembly language program. So first we are making certain assumptions. We are assuming the input data, let's say the first number is 15 and the second number is 25. We are assuming the memory address of the input data, let's say 15 is stored in the memory address 0000 and 25 is stored in the memory address 0001. And since we know the maximum of these two decimal numbers is 25, so we are also assuming this output data, that is 25, is to be stored in the memory address 0002. So after considering these assumptions, I have drawn a flowchart, and let's understand how we'll use this algorithm using these assumptions. First of all, we load the two numbers in register pair HL. So what will happen is first number, that is 15, will come in the register L, and the second number 25 will come in the register H. So we have the two numbers in two different registers. In second step, what we'll do is we'll move one of the number, let's say the number in the register H, into the accumulator. So now accumulator has the second number, that is 25, and L has the value 15. Now in third step, what we will do is the number which is in accumulator will subtract another number, that is in L, from the accumulator. So what we will get is 15, we will subtract 15 from 25. So 25 minus 15, we will get plus 10. So there can be two cases can arise from here. From this particular example, we are getting the result positive. So if the result is positive, that we are subtracting the number in L from the number in accumulator, and accumulator indirectly has the number which was stored in H, and the result is positive, that means the number in H was greater. So what we'll do is the number in H was greater, so we have to give the output, as the output should be the number which is contained in H. So for this, what we'll do is we'll move the number from H into the accumulator, and then the value which is stored in the accumulator, we'll move or store that in memory address, which we've assumed to the memory address of output, that is 0002. And then the program will end. If the numbers were the other way around, if the greater number was in L, let's say L was 25 and H was 15. So in this step, we are subtracting 25 from 15, then the result will be negative, and the result is negative, then we know that the number in L has to be greater, so we'll move the number in L to the accumulator, and the value that is stored in the accumulator, we'll store that at the memory address 0002, and the program will end. Now we have to write the code for this, and for writing the code we are using this micro 8085 microprocessor simulators, GNU Sim 8085. In this, I have already written the code. Here we have, on the left side, we have the registers and flags, and here we have this. Here, from here, we can update the memory. First of all, what we'll do is we'll reset everything, flags, registers, and memory, because I have already run this program. So we'll reset everything, all the registers and flags are reset, and or the memory input, there is no input. So first of all, we need to put the input at 0000. This is the hexadecimal representation of the memory location, and this is the decimal representation, and here we have decimal representation. So at 0 we need 15, so we'll update the memory. At 1 we need 25. Now we have the input 15 and 25. Now we need the output at 0002, and the output should be 25. So we'll write the program. I've already written the program. We'll execute it step by step. So from here we can execute it line by line. First instruction is LHLD 0000. Now what this instruction does is it loads the directly this the value at this memory location into the HL pair. HL pair means that the memory at this location will be stored in the register L, and the memory at just next location, that is 0001, will be stored in the register H. So when this is executed, we get the HL pair has some values which is in hexadecimal. L has OF, which is OF is, if we convert 25 to hexadecimal, this is where we can do decimal to hex conversion, we get 19. So 25 was in 0001, which was supposed to go in H. So in hexadecimal it is 19, and 15 is OF. So now we have these two numbers in H and L. Now what we have to do is we have to move one of the number to the accumulator, and then we have to compare with the another number by subtracting. So this will execute, and the number in H has now moved to the accumulator. Now we have to subtract the number in register L from the accumulator. Now in accumulator we have the number in H, that is 25, and in L we have 15. So the result has to be positive. So what will happen is, when the result is positive, but what I have done is JP skip. The result is positive, then the skip is a variable here, and to move when the result is positive, this, let's do this here. Now JP skip, result is positive. So now we have to come to skip. When the result is positive, we'll come to skip. And now if the result is positive, we know that we are subtracting L from H, and result has come positive. So H has to be greater. So we'll move H to the accumulator. H has been moved to accumulator. Accumulator has now the value which was in H. Now we need the output in the memory location 0002. So this will load the value in stored in the accumulator at this memory location, and then halt. So we have at 0002 we have the output 25. Now what if the things were other way around? If the greater number was stored in another register, let's say at 00, now we'll reverse the memory. First of all, we'll reset everything and we'll reverse the memory. At 0 we'll have 25, and at 1 we'll have 15. So the memory is updated. Now if we'll execute this, HL pair is loaded with this input. We have moved H to A, and we have subtracted, and now we are subtracting H L from H. So the answer has to be negative 25 15 minus 25. We are subtracting 25 from 15. So what now we know the answer is negative. That means L has to be greater. So we will execute fifth step. We'll move the value in L to A, and then we'll store the value in accumulator in the memory location 0002. That is the output, and then we'll halt. Now we have the answer in 0002. So this is how we find the maximum of 28-bit numbers in 8085 assembly language.